أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم.
ولو أننا نزلنا إليهم الملائكة وكلمهم الموتى وحشرنا عليهم كل شيء قبلا ما كانوا ليؤمنوا إلا أن يشاء الله ولكن أكثرهم يجهلون. وكذلك جعلنا لكل نبي عدوا شياطين الإنس والجن يوحي بعضهم إلى بعض زخرف القول غرورا. ولو شاء ربك ما فعلوه فذرهم وما يفترون. ولتصغى إليه أفئدة الذين لا يؤمنون بالآخرة وليرضوه وليقترفوا ما هم مقترفون. أفغير الله أبتغي حكما وهو الذي أنزل إليكم الكتاب مفصلا. والذين آتيناهم الكتاب يعلمون أنه منزل من ربك بالحق فلا تكونن من الممترين. وتمت كلمة ربك صدقا وعدلا لا مبدل لكلماته وهو السميع العليم.
Even if we had sent to them the angels, made the dead to speak to them, and presented all the different things of the world before them as proof, they would have not believed unless Allah wanted otherwise. Yet most of them act out of ignorance. Like this Rasul, we had granted each Rasul his opponents, shaitans from among human beings and jinns. Some of them inspired others with seductive discourses of deception. If your Rabb wanted, they would not have done so. Therefore, neglect them as well as what they invent, so that the hearts of those who do not believe in the hereafter may be inclined to what they say and be pleased with it, and so that they can earn what they wish to earn. Say, should I seek a judge other than Allah, when he is the one who has revealed this book with full details? Those whom we gave the book before you know very well that it is revealed to you from your Rabb with the truth. Therefore, you should not be of those who have doubts. The words of your Rabb have been completed with credibility and justice. There is no way to change his words. He is the hearer, the knower.
وإن تطع أكثر من في الأرض يضلوك عن سبيل الله إن يتبعون إلا الظن وإن هم إلا يخرصون. إن ربك هو أعلم من يضل عن سبيله وهو أعلم بالمهتدين. فكلوا مما ذكر اسم الله عليه إن كنتم بآياته مؤمنين. وما لكم ألا تأكلوا مما ذكر اسم الله عليه وقد فصل لكم ما حرم عليكم إلا ما اضطررتم إليه. وإن كثيرا ليضلون بأهوائهم بغير علم. إن ربك هو أعلم بالمعتدين. وذروا ظاهر الإثم وباطنه. إن الذين يكسبون الإثم سيجزون بما كانوا يقترفون.
ولا تأكلوا مما لم يذكر اسم الله عليه وإنه لفسق. وإن الشياطين ليوحون إلى أوليائهم ليجادلوكم. وإن أطعتموهم إنكم لمشركون.
If you obey, most of the people of the earth will lead you away from the way of Allah, for they follow nothing but guesswork and preach nothing but falsehood. In fact, your Rabb knows best those people who have strayed from his way, and he knows best those who are on the right way. So eat of that meat on which Allah's name has been pronounced if you truly believe in his revelations. Why should you not eat of that on which Allah's name has been pronounced when he has clearly spelled out for you in detail what is forbidden, except in a case of extreme helplessness? In fact, many do mislead people by their appetites unchecked by knowledge. Your Rabb knows best those who transgress. Eschew all sin, whether open or secret. Surely those who earn sin will get due punishment for their wrongdoings. Do not eat of that meat on which Allah's name has not been pronounced, since that is most surely a transgression. In fact, the shaitans inspire their friends that they should argue with you, and if you obey them, most surely you will be considered a mushrik.
يمشي به في الناس كمن مثله في الظلمات ليس بخارج منها كذلك زين للكافرين ما كانوا يعملون وكذلك جعلنا في كل قرية أكابر مجرميها ليمكروا فيها وما يمكرون إلا بأنفسهم وما يشعرون وإذا جاءتهم آية قالوا لن نؤمن حتى نؤتى مثل ما أوتي رسل الله الله أعلم حيث يجعل رسالته سيصيب الذين أجرموا صغار عند الله وعذاب شديد بما كانوا
Can a person who was dead and whom we raised to life and gave the light to walk with among people be like the one who is in the depths of darkness from which he can never come out? Since they treat both of them alike, the actions of the unbelievers are made lucrative to them. And that is why in every town we have placed the criminals as their ringleaders to plot therein. They plot against none but their own souls, though they do not perceive it. Whenever there comes to them a sign, they say, We shall not believe until we are given directly that which is given to the Rasuls of Allah. Allah knows best to whom he should give his message. Soon these criminals will be overtaken by humiliation and by a severe punishment from Allah for their evil plots.
فمن يرد الله أن يهديه يشرح صدره للإسلام ومن يرد أن يضله يجعل صدره ضيقا حرجا كأنما يصعد في السماء كذلك يجعل الله الرجس على الذين لا يؤمنون وهذا صراط ربك مستقيما قد فصلنا الآيات لقوم يذكرون لهم دار السلام عند ربهم وهو وليهم بما كانوا يعملون
Whomever Allah wills to guide, He opens His chest to Islam. And whomever He intends to confound, He makes His chest narrow and squeezes so tight that at the very idea of Islam, He feels as if His soul is going to climb up towards the sky. That is how Allah places a blight on those who do not believe. Whereas in fact, this way is the right way of your Rabb, and we have spelled out our revelations very clearly for the people who use their common sense. For them there will be a home of peace with their Rabb. He will be their protector because of their good deeds.
ويوم يحشرهم جميعا يا معشر الجن قد استكثرتم من الإنس وقال أولياؤهم من الإنس ربنا استمتع بعضنا ببعض وبلغنا أجلنا الذي أجلت لنا قال النار مثواكم خالدين فيها إلا ما شاء الله إن ربك حكيم عليم وكذلك نولي بعض الظالمين بعضا بما كانوا يكسبون
On the day when he will assemble them all together, O assembly of jinns, You seduced mankind in great numbers, and their votaries from among mankind will say, Our Rabb, we have both enjoyed each other's fellowship, but alas, now we have reached the end of our term which you had decreed for us. Then Allah will say, Now hellfire is your dwelling place. You will live therein forever unless Allah ordains otherwise. Surely your Rabb is wise, knowledgeable. That is how in the hereafter we will make the wrongdoers the comrades of one another on account of what they earned during their life on earth with evil friendship.
يا معشر الجن والإنس ألم يأتكم رسل منكم يقصون عليكم آياتي وينذرونكم لقاء يومكم هذا قالوا شهدنا على أنفسنا وغرتهم الحياة الدنيا وشهدوا على أنفسهم أنهم كانوا كافرين ذلك أن لم يكن ربك مهلك القرى بظلم وأهلها غافلون ولكل درجات مما عملوا وما ربك بغافل عما يعملون وربك الغني ذو الرحمة إن يشأ يذهبكم ويستخلف من بعدكم ما يشاء كما أنشأكم من ذرية قوم آخرين إنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين قل يا قوم اعملوا على مكانتكم إني عامل فسوف تعلمون من تكون له عاقبة الدار إنه لا يفلح الظالمون.
At that time Allah will also ask, O assembly of jinns and mankind, did not there come to you the Rasuls from amongst you who proclaimed to you my revelations and warned you about the meeting of this day? They will reply, Yes, they did. We bear witness against our own souls. Today this worldly life has deceived them, but on that day they will testify against themselves that they were indeed kuffar. This testimony will be taken in order to prove that your Rabb would not destroy towns without just cause while their residents were ignorant of the reality. All will be awarded ranks according to their deeds, and your Rabb is not unaware of what they do. Your Rabb is self-sufficient, Lord of mercy. If he wants, he can destroy you all and replace you with others as he pleases, just as he raised you from the offspring of other people. Surely what you are being threatened with must come to pass, and you can do nothing about it. O Muhammad, tell them, O my people, if you don't listen to me, do whatever you want, and I'll do whatever I deem right. You will soon find out who is to gain the reward of the hereafter. Rest assured that the wrongdoers will not get salvation.
وجعلوا لله مما ذرأ من الحرث والأنعام نصيبا فقالوا هذا لله بزعمهم وهذا لشركائنا فما كان لشركائهم فلا يصل إلى الله وما كان لله فهو يصل إلى شركائهم ساء وكذلك زين لكثير من المشركين قتل أولادهم شركاؤهم ليردوهم وليلبسوا عليهم دينهم ولو شاء الله ما فعلوه فذرهم وما يفترون وقالوا هذه أنعام وحرث حجر لا يطعمها إلا من نشاء بزعمهم وأنعام حرمت ظهورها وأنعام لا يذكرون اسم الله عليها افتراء عليه سيجزيهم بما كانوا يفترون وقالوا ما في بطون هذه الأنعام خالصة لذكورنا ومحرم على أزواجنا وإن يكن ميتة فهم فيه شركاء سيجزيهم وصفهم إنه حكيم عليم قد خسر الذين قتلوا أولادهم سفها بغير علم وحرموا ما رزقهم الله افتراء على الله قد ضلوا وما كانوا مهتدين.
They set aside a share of their produce and of their cattle for Allah, saying, "This is for Allah," so they pretend, "and this is for our sharaka." Their sharaka's share does not reach Allah, but the share of Allah is wholly given to sharaka. What an evil decision they make. Their sharaka have induced many mushrikeen to kill their own children in order to ruin them and confuse them in their religion. If Allah wanted, they would not have done so. Therefore, leave them alone with their false inventions. These mushrikeen say that such and such cattle and crops are reserved in the name of such and such temple, and no one should eat except those whom we permit. In fact, these restrictions they themselves have imposed. Then there are some animals which they have prohibited from riding or carrying loads, and there are still other animals over which they do not pronounce the name of Allah. They have falsely attributed all these things to Him. Soon He will requite them for their invented lies. They also say the offspring of these cattle is specially reserved for our males and forbidden to our females, but if it is stillborn, then all can share together. Soon He will punish them for their attribution of such superstitions to Allah. Surely He is wise, knowledgeable. Actual losers are those who kill their own children foolishly, without knowledge, and forbid food which Allah has provided them, falsely ascribing prohibitions to Allah. Certainly they have gone astray and are not at all rightly guided.
وهو الذي أنشأ جنات معروشات وغير معروشات والنخل والزرع مختلفا أكله والزيتون والرمان متشابها وغير متشابه كلوا من ثمره إذا أثمر وآتوا حقه يوم حصاده ولا تسرفوا إنه لا يحب المسرفين ومن الأنعام حمولة وفرشا كلوا مما رزقكم الله ولا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان إنه لكم عدو مبين.
It is He who has created all kinds of plants, trestled and untrestled, the palm trees, the field crops with produce of different kinds, the olives and pomegranates, similar in kind yet different in taste. Eat of their fruit in their season and give away their zakah on the harvest day. Do not be spendthrift. Surely He does not love the spendthrifts. Of the animals you have, some are for transportation and some for slaughter. Eat of that which Allah has provided for you, and do not follow the footsteps of Shaitan. Surely he is your open enemy.
8 من الضأن 2 ومن المعز 2 قل أذكرين حرم أم الأنثيين أم اشتملت عليه أرحام الأنثيين نبئوني بعلم إن كنتم صادقين ومن الإبل 2 ومن البقر 2 قل أذكرين حرم أم الأنثيين أم اشتملت عليه أرحام الأنثيين أم كنتم شهداء إذ وصاكم الله بهذا فمن أظلم ممن افترى على الله كذبا ليضل الناس بغير علم إن الله لا يهدي القوم الظالمين.
For 8 heads of cattle, male and female, there are superstitions. Take a pair of sheep and a pair of goats, for example, and ask them, "Of these, has He forbidden you the males, females, or their fetuses? Answer me based on knowledge, not superstition, if what you say is true." Likewise, ask them about a pair of camels and a pair of cows. Of these, has He forbidden you the males, females, or their fetuses? If they answer, then ask them, "Were you present when Allah gave you these commandments?" If not, then, Who can be more unjust than the one who forges a lie against Allah so that he may mislead mankind without having any knowledge? Surely Allah does not guide the unjust people.
قُلْ لَا أَجِدُ فِي مَا أُوحِيَ إِلَيَّ مُحَرَّمًا عَلَى طَاعِمٍ يَطْعَمُهُ إِلَّا أَنْ يَكُونَ مَيْتَةً أَوْ دَمًا مَسْفُوحًا أَوْ لَحْمَ خِنْزِيرٍ فَإِنَّهُ رِجْسٌ أَوْ فِسْقًا أُهِلَّ لِغَيْرِ اللَّهِ بِهِ فَمَنِ اضْطُرَّ غَيْرَ بَاغٍ وَلَا عَادٍ فَإِنَّ رَبَّكَ غَفُورٌ رَّحِيمٌ وَعَلَى الَّذِينَ هَادُوا حَرَّمْنَا كُلَّ ذِي ظُفْرٍ وَمِنَ الْبَقَرِ وَالْغَنَمِ حَرَّمْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ شُحُومَهُمَا إِلَّا مَا حَمَلَتْ ظُهُورُهُمَا أَوِ الْحَوَايَا أَوْ مَا اخْتَلَطَ بِعَظْمٍ ذَلِكَ جَزَيْنَاهُمْ بِبَغْيِهِمْ وَإِنَّا لَصَادِقُونَ فإن كذبوك فقل ربكم ذو رحمة واسعة ولا يرد بأسه عن القوم المجرمين.
O Muhammad, tell them, I did not find in what has been revealed to me anything forbidden to be eaten by one who wishes to eat it, except the meat of an already dead animal, or running blood, or the flesh of swine, for these are unclean. Or flesh of an animal which has become profane because of slaughtering in the names other than Allah. Even so, if anyone is forced in helpless situation, intending neither disobedience nor transgression, you will find your Rabb forgiving, merciful. For those who are Jews, we forbade every animal with undivided hoofs and the fat of oxen and sheep, except what is attached to their backs or their intestines or is mixed with their bones. This was the punishment we inflicted for their willful disobedience. What we said is true. Now, if they disbelieve you, say, your Rabb is the owner of boundless mercy, but his scourge cannot be averted from criminal people.
سيقول الذين أشركوا لو شاء الله ما أشركنا ولا آباؤنا ولا حرمنا من شيء كذلك كذب الذين من قبلهم حتى ذاقوا بأسنا قل هل عندكم من علم فتخرجوه لنا إن تتبعون إلا الظن وإن أنتم إلا تخرصون قل فلله الحجة البالغة فلو شاء لهداكم أجمعين قل هلم شهداءكم الذين يشهدون أن الله حرم هذا فإن شهدوا فلا تشهد معهم ولا تتبع أهواء الذين كذبوا بآياتنا والذين لا يؤمنون بالآخرة وهم بربهم يعدلون.
In response to this, the mushrikeen will promptly say, if Allah wanted, neither we nor our forefathers would have been mushrikeen, or we could have made anything unlawful. That is how their ancestors rejected the truth in the past until they tasted our punishment. If they say so, then ask them, do you have any evidence that you can put before us? The fact of the matter is, you believe in nothing but conjecture and follow nothing but falsehood. Say, in contrast to your position, Allah's argument is conclusive. If it had been His will, He could indeed have guided you all. Say, bring your witnesses to prove that Allah did forbid so and so. Even if they so testify, do not testify with them, nor yield to the wishes of those who deny our revelations, disbelieve in the hereafter, and set up others as equals with their Rabb.
قل تعالوا أتل ما حرم ربكم عليكم ألا تشركوا به شيئا وبالوالدين إحسانا ولا تقتلوا أولادكم من إملاق نحن نرزقكم وإياهم ولا تقربوا الفواحش ما ظهر منها وما بطن ولا تقتلوا النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق ذلكم وصاكم به لعلكم تعقلون ولا تقربوا مال اليتيم إلا بالتي هي أحسن حتى يبلغ أشده وأوفوا الكيل والميزان بالقسط لا نكلف نفسا إلا وسعها وإذا قلتم فاعدلوا ولو كان ذا قربى وبعهد الله أوفوا ذلكم وصاكم به لعلكم تذكرون وأن هذا صراطي مستقيما فاتبعوه ولا تتبعوا السبل فتفرق بكم عن سبيله ذلكم وصاكم به لعلكم تتقون ثم آتينا موسى الكتاب تماما على الذي أحسن وتفصيلا لكل شيء وهدى ورحمة لعلهم بلقاء ربهم يؤمنون
O Muhammad, say, Come, I will recite what your Rabb has forbidden to you, not to commit shirk with him, to be kind to your parents, not to kill your children, making the excuse of inability to support them. We provide sustenance for you and for them. Not to commit shameful deeds, whether open or secret, not to kill any soul forbidden by Allah, except for the requirements of justice. These are the things which He enjoined you, so that you may learn wisdom. Furthermore, not to go near the property of an orphan except in the best way, until he attains maturity. Give full measure and just weight. We never charge a soul with more than it can bear. Whenever you speak, be just, even if it affects your own relatives, and fulfill your covenant with Allah. These are the things which He has enjoined on you, so that you may be mindful. He has also said, Verily, this is my way, the right way. Therefore, follow it, and do not follow other ways, for they will lead you away from Him. This is what He enjoined on you, so that you may guard yourselves against evil. Moreover, he said, We gave Musa the book to complete our favor on those who would do good to others. It contained details of all things and was a guide and a mercy so that they should believe in the ultimate meeting with their Rabb.
وهذا كتاب أنزلناه مبارك فاتبعوه واتقوا لعلكم ترحمون أن تقولوا إنما أنزل الكتاب على طائفتين من قبلنا وإن كنا عن دراستهم لغافلين أو تقولوا لو أنا أنزل علينا الكتاب لكنا أهدى منهم فقد جاءكم بينة من ربكم وهدى ورحمة فمن أظلم ممن كذب بآيات الله وصدف عنها سنجزي الذين يصدفون عن آياتنا سوء العذاب بما كانوا يصدفون هل ينظرون إلا أن تأتيهم الملائكة أو يأتي ربك أو يأتي بعض آيات ربك يوم يأتي بعض آيات ربك لا ينفع نفسا إيمانها لم تكن آمنت من قبل أو كسبت في إيمانها خيرا قل انتظروا إنا منتظرون
We have revealed this book similar to the book given to Musa as a blessing. Therefore, follow it and adopt a God-fearing attitude so that you may receive mercy. Lest you say, the book was revealed only to two parties before us and we were unaware of what they read. Or lest you say, if the book had been revealed to us, we could have followed its guidance better than them. A veritable sign has now come to you from your Rabb as a guidance and mercy. Who then is more unjust than the one who denies the revelations of Allah and turns away from them? Verily soon those who turn away from our revelations will face dreadful punishment for their aversion. Are they waiting for the angels or your Rabb to come down to them? Or are they waiting to be given a certain sign of your Rabb? On the day when that certain sign of your Rabb appears, the belief will not profit that soul which did not believe before, or who, while professing to believe, did not do good deeds. Say to them, wait if you will. We too are waiting.
إن الذين فرقوا دينهم وكانوا شيعا لست منهم في شيء إنما أمرهم إلى الله ثم ينبئهم بما كانوا يفعلون من جاء بالحسنة فله عشر أمثالها ومن جاء
Surely those who divide the religion into sects and identify themselves as a sect, O Muhammad, you have nothing to do with them. Their case will be called to account by Allah Himself. He will inform them as to what they did. Whoever does one good deed, he will be given credit for 10 similar good deeds. And whoever does one bad deed will be punished for only one, and no one will be treated unjustly.
قل إنني هداني ربي إلى صراط مستقيم دينا قيما ملة إبراهيم حنيفا وما كان من المشركين قل إن صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين لا شريك له وبذلك أمرت وأنا أول المسلمين قل أغير الله أبغي ربا وهو رب كل شيء ولا تكسب كل نفس إلا عليها ولا تزر وازرة وزر أخرى ثم إلى ربكم مرجعكم فينبئكم بما كنتم فيه تختلفون وهو الذي جعلكم خلائف الأرض ورفع بعضكم فوق بعض درجات ليبلوكم فيما آتاكم إن ربك سريع العقاب وإنه لغفور رحيم
O Muhammad, tell them, as for me, surely my Rabb has guided me to the right way, the ever-true deen, the faith of Ibrahim, the upright, and he was not of the mushrikeen. Also declare, surely my salah, my devotion, my life, and my death are all for Allah, the Rabb of the worlds. He has no peer, thus I am commanded, and I am the first of the Muslims. Say, should I seek another Rabb besides Allah, when he is the Rabb of everything? Every soul will reap the fruits of its own deeds. No bearer of burden shall bear the burden of another. Ultimately, you will return to your Rabb, and he will resolve for you your disputes. He is the one who has made you the inheritors of the earth, and raised some of you in ranks over others, so that he may test you in what he has given you. Surely your Rabb is swift in retribution. Yet, He is also very forgiving, merciful.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألف لام ميم صاد كتاب أنزل إليك فلا يكن في صدرك حرج منه لتنذر به وذكرى للمؤمنين اتبعوا ما أنزل إليكم من ربكم ولا تتبعوا من دونه أولياء قليلا ما تذكرون وكم من قرية أهلكناها فجاءها بأسنا بياتا أو هم قائلون فما كان دعواهم إذ جاءهم بأسنا إلا أن قالوا إنا كنا ظالمين فلنسألن الذين أرسل إليهم ولنسألن المرسلين فلنقصن عليهم بعلم وما كنا غائبين والوزن يومئذ الحق فمن ثقلت موازينه فأولئك هم المفلحون ومن خفت موازينه فأولئك الذين خسروا أنفسهم بما كانوا بآياتنا يظلمون ولقد مكناكم في الأرض وجعلنا لكم فيها معايش قليلا ما تشكرون.
In the name of Allah, the compassionate, the merciful. Alif Lam Mim Sad. This book is revealed to you. Let there be no hesitation in your heart about it, so that you may thereby warn the unbelievers and remind the believers. Say, O people, follow what has been brought down to you from your Rabb, and do not follow other patrons beside him. Yet little do they take admonition. How many towns have we destroyed for their sins? Our scourge took them all of a sudden, at night, or while they were taking their afternoon rest. And when our scourge fell upon them, their only cry was, "We have indeed been wrongdoers." On the day of judgment, we shall question those to whom Rasuls were sent, and we shall also question the Rasuls about our message and its response. Then we shall tell their whole story as an eyewitness, for we were never absent at any time or from any place. On that day the scale of justice shall be established. Those whose scale of good deeds will be heavy, they are the ones who will attain felicity. And those whose scale is light, they shall find themselves in loss, for they had done injustice to our revelations. We are the one who established you on the earth, and provided you means of your sustenance therein, yet little is it that you pay in thanks.
ولقد خلقناكم ثم صورناكم ثم قلنا للملائكة اسجدوا لآدم فسجدوا إلا إبليس لم يكن من الساجدين قال ما منعك ألا تسجد إذ أمرتك قال أنا خير منه خلقتني من نار وخلقته من طين قال فاهبط منها فما يكون لك أن تتكبر فيها فاخرج إنك من الصاغرين قال أنظرني إلى يوم يبعثون قال إنك من المنظرين قال فبما أغويتني لأقعدن لهم صراطك المستقيم ثم لآتينهم من بين أيديهم ومن خلفهم وعن أيمانهم وعن شمائلهم ولا تجد أكثرهم شاكرين قال اخرج منها مذءوما مدحورا لمن تبعك منهم لأملأن جهنم منكم أجمعين.
Indeed we created you, then we fashioned you, then we asked the angels, prostrate yourselves before Adam. They all prostrated accordingly, except Iblis, who did not join those who prostrated. Allah said, what prevented you from prostrating when I commanded you? He replied, I am better than he. You created me from fire and him from clay. Allah said, get down from here. You have no right to brag here of your superiority. Get out of here. Henceforth, you are of the petty ones. Shaitan requested, give me respite till the day of resurrection. Allah said, the respite you requested is hereby granted. Shaitan declared, since you let me deviate, now I will lie in ambush for mankind on your straight way. I will come upon them from the front and from the rear, from the right and from the left, and you will not find most of them to be grateful. Allah said, Get out from here, you despicable outcast. I will certainly fill hell with you and all of them who follow you.
ويا آدم اسكن أنت وزوجك الجنة فكلا من حيث شئتما ولا تقربا هذه الشجرة فتكونا من الظالمين فوسوس لهما الشيطان ليبدي لهما ما وري عنهما من سوآتهما وقال ما رهاكما ربكما عن هذه الشجرة إلا أن تكونا ملكين أو تكونا من الخالدين وقاسمهما إني لكما لمن الناصحين فدلاهما بغرور فلما ذاق الشجرة بدت لهما سوآتهما وطفقا يخصفان عليهما من ورق الجنة وناداهما ربهما ألم أنهكما عن تلكما الشجرة وأقل لكما إن الشيطان لكما عدو مبين قالا ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين قال اهبطوا بعضكم لبعض عدو ولكم في الأرض مستقر ومتاع إلى حين قال فيها تحيون وفيها تموتون ومنها تخرجون
Allah said, O Adam, dwell with your wife in paradise and eat any fruit you please, but never approach this tree, or you shall both become wrongdoers. But Shaitan tempted them so that he might reveal to them the private parts of their bodies which they had never seen before. He told them, Your Rabb has forbidden you to approach this tree only to prevent you from becoming angels or immortals. And he swore to them both, I am your sincere adviser. Thus he cunningly seduced them, and when they ate from the tree, their shame became visible to them, and they began to cover themselves with leaves from the garden. Then their Rabb called out to them, Did I not forbid you to approach that tree, and did I not warn you that Shaitan was your open enemy? They both replied, Our Rabb, we have wronged our souls. If you do not forgive us and have mercy on us, we shall certainly be of the losers. Allah said, Go down. Some of you are the enemy of others. The earth will be your dwelling place and your means of livelihood for a fixed term. He further said, Therein you shall live, and therein you shall die, and therefrom you shall be raised to life.
يا بني آدم قد أنزلنا عليكم لباسا يواري سوآتكم وريشا ولباس التقوى ذلك خير ذلك من آيات الله لعلهم يذكرون يا بني آدم لا يفتننكم الشيطان كما أخرج أبويكم من الجنة ينزع عنهما لباسهما ليريهما سوآتهما إنه يراكم هو وقبيله من حيث لا ترونهم إنا جعلنا الشياطين أولياء للذين لا يؤمنون وإذا فعلوا فاحشة قالوا وجدنا عليها آباءنا والله أمرنا بها قل إن الله لا يأمر بالفحشاء أتقولون على الله ما لا تعلمون قل أمر ربي بالقسط وأقيموا وجوهكم عند كل مسجد وادعوه مخلصين له الدين كما بدأكم تعودون فريقا هدى وفريقا حق عليهم الضلالة إنهم اتخذوا الشياطين أولياء من دون الله ويحسبون أنهم مهتدون يا بني آدم خذوا زينتكم صلاتكم عند كل مسجد وكلوا واشربوا ولا تسرفوا إنه لا يحب المسرفين.
O children of Adam, we have sent down to you clothing to cover your nakedness and as an adornment. However, the best clothing is the clothing of piety. This is one of Allah's revelations so that the people may learn a lesson. O children of Adam, let not Shaitan seduce you in the same manner as he seduced your parents out of paradise, through stripping them of their clothing in order to expose their nakedness. He and his tribe watch you from where you cannot see them. We have permitted the Shaitans to be the guardians over the unbelievers. Whenever they commit a shameful deed, they say, "We found our forefathers doing this, and Allah Himself has commanded us to do so." Tell them, "Nay, Allah never commands what is shameful. Do you attribute to Allah something about which you have no knowledge? O Muhammad, say to them, "My Rabb has commanded justice, and that you set your faces in the right direction at the time of every prayer, and call on Him with true devotion. You shall return to Him as He created you in the beginning." To one group He has guided, while the other group deserved to be left in error due to their own choice, for they took the Shaitans for their protectors instead of Allah. Yet they think that they are guided. O children of Adam, put on your adornment when you attend your masjid at the time of every prayer. Eat and drink, but do not be extravagant. Surely He does not love the extravagant.
قل من حرم زينة الله التي أخرج لعباده والطيبات من الرزق قل هي للذين آمنوا في الحياة الدنيا خالصة يوم القيامة كذلك نفصل الآيات لقوم يعلمون قل إنما حرم ربي الفواحش ما ظهر منها وما بطن والإثم والبغي بغير الحق وأن تشركوا بالله ما لم ينزل به سلطانا وأن تقولوا على الله ما لا تعلمون ولكل أمة أجل فإذا جاء أجلهم لا يستأخرون ساعة ولا يستقدمون.
O Muhammad, ask them, who has forbidden you to wear decent clothes or to eat the good food which Allah has provided for His devotees? Say, all these things are for the enjoyment of the believers in the life of this world, though shared by others. But these shall be exclusively theirs on the day of resurrection. Thus do we make our revelations clear for those who understand. Say, my Rabb has forbidden all indecencies, whether open or secret, sin and rebellion against justice, committing shirk with Allah for which He has granted no sanction, and saying things about Allah of which you have no knowledge. For every nation there is a fixed term. When their term expires, it can neither be delayed for a moment, nor can it be made to come early.
يا بني آدم إما يأتينكم رسل منكم يقصون عليكم آياتي فمن اتقى وأصلح فلا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون والذين كذبوا بآياتنا واستكبروا عنها أولئك أصحاب النار هم فيها خالدون فمن أظلم ممن افترى على الله كذبا أو كذب بآياته أولئك ينالهم نصيبهم من الكتاب حتى إذا جاءتهم رسلنا يتوفونهم قالوا أينما كنتم تدعون من دون الله قالوا ضلوا عنا وشهدوا على أنفسهم أنهم كانوا كافرين قال ادخلوا في أمم قد خلت من قبلكم من الجن والإنس في النار كلما دخلت أمة لعنت أختها حتى إذا اداركوا فيها جميعا قالت أخراهم لأولاهم ربنا هؤلاء أضلونا فآتهم عذابا ضعفا من النار قال لكل ضعف ولكن لا تعلمون وقالت أولاهم لأخراهم فما كان لكم علينا من فضل فذوقوا العذاب بما كنتم تكسبون
O children of Adam, whenever there come to you rasuls from among you and recite to you my revelations, those who will become righteous and mend their ways will have nothing to fear or to regret. But those who deny our revelations and treat them with arrogance shall be the inmates of hellfire to live therein forever. Who can be more unjust than the one who invents a lie against Allah or rejects his revelations? Such people will have their destined portion from the book until when our messengers arrive to take away their souls, they will ask, Where are those gods whom you used to invoke besides Allah? They will reply, They have forsaken us. And they will bear witness against themselves that they were indeed kuffar. Allah will say, Enter the fire and join the nations of jinns and men who have gone before you. As each nation will enter hell, it will curse its preceding sister till all are gathered there. The last of them will say about the first, Our Rabb, these have led us astray, therefore give them double punishment of the fire. He will answer, There will be double for all, although you may not know, because of being predecessor or successor in sin and aggression. Then the first will say to the last, If we were to blame, you too were no better than us. Now taste the penalty of your misdeeds.
إن الذين كذبوا بآياتنا واستكبروا عنها لا تفتح لهم أبواب السماء ولا يدخلون الجنة حتى يلج الجمل في سم الخياط وكذلك نجزي المجرمين لهم من جهنم مهاد ومن فوقهم غواش وكذلك نجزي الظالمين
Surely the gates of heaven will not be opened for those who deny our revelations and treat them with arrogance. Their admission into paradise will be as impossible as the passing of a camel through the eye of a needle. That is how we shall reward the criminals. Hell shall be their bed, and flames shall be their covering. That is how we shall reward the wrongdoers.
والذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات لا نكلف نفسا إلا وسعها أولئك أصحاب الجنة هم فيها خالدون ونزعنا ما في صدورهم من غل تجري من تحتهم الأنهار وقالوا الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله لقد جاءت رسل ربنا بالحق ونودوا أن تلكم الجنة أورثتموها بما كنتم تعملون
As for those who believe and do good deeds, we never burden a soul with more than it can bear. They are worthy of paradise, wherein they will live forever. We shall remove whatever ill feeling they may have in their hearts against one another. Rivers will be flowing beneath them, and they will say, Praise be to Allah, who guided us this way. We would have never found the right way if Allah had not guided us. The Rasuls of our Rabb have surely preached us the truth. At that time, they will hear the announcement, "This is paradise, which you have inherited because of your good deeds."
ونادى أصحاب الجنة أصحاب النار أن قد وجدنا ما وعدنا ربنا حقا فهل وجدتم ما وعد ربكم حقا قالوا نعم فأذن مؤذن بينهم اللعنة الله على الظالمين الذين يصدون عن سبيل الله ويبغونها عوجا وهم بالآخرة كافرون وبينهما حجاب وعلى الأعراف رجال يعرفون كلا بسيماهم ونادوا أصحاب الجنة أن سلام عليكم لم يدخلوها وهم يطمعون وإذا صرفت أبصارهم تلقاء أصحاب النار قالوا ربنا لا تجعلنا مع القوم الظالمين
The residents of paradise will call out to the inmates of hellfire. We have indeed found out the promises of our Rabb to be true. Have you too found the promise of your Rabb to be true? Yes, they will answer. And a herald will proclaim among them, "The curse of Allah be upon the wrongdoers, who hindered other people from the way of Allah and sought to make it crooked, and who did not believe in the hereafter." Between the two, there shall be a veil, and on the Araf there will be people who will recognize them by their features. They will call out to the residents of paradise, "Peace be upon you." They will not have yet entered, though they will have the hope. When their eyes shall turn towards the inmates of hellfire, they will say, "Our Rabb, do not cast us among the wrongdoers."
ونادى أصحاب الأعراف رجالا يعرفونهم بسيماهم قالوا ما أغنى عنكم جمعكم وما كنتم تستكبرون أهؤلاء الذين أقسمتم لا ينالهم الله برحمة أدخلوا الجنة لا خوف عليكم ولا أنتم تحزنون ونادى أصحاب النار أصحاب الجنة أن أفيضوا علينا من الماء أو مما رزقكم الله قالوا إن الله حرمهما على الكافرين الذين اتخذوا دينهم لهوا ولعبا وغرتهم الحياة الدنيا فاليوم ننساهم كما نسوا لقاء يومهم هذا وما كانوا بآياتنا يجحدون ولقد جئناهم بكتاب فصلناه على علم هدى ورحمة لقوم يؤمنون هل ينظرون إلا تأويله يوم يأتي تأويله يقول الذين نسوه من قبل قد جاءت رسل ربنا بالحق فهل لنا من شفعاء فيشفعوا لنا أو نرد فنعمل غير الذي كنا نعمل قد خسروا أنفسهم وضل عنهم ما كانوا يفترون
The people of the Araf will call to certain men whom they will recognize by their features and say, "Have you found out that neither your riches nor your arrogant pride have availed you? Are the residents of paradise not the same people about whom you swore that Allah will never bestow his mercy on them? Today the same people are being welcomed with the words, 'Enter paradise, you have nothing to fear or to regret.'" Then the inmates of the fire will cry out to the residents of paradise, "Give us some water or some of the food which Allah has provided you." They will reply, "Allah has prohibited both of these things to the unbelievers, who took their religion to be mere amusement and play and were deceived by the earthly life." Allah will say, "Today we will forget them as they forgot the meeting of this day, and mocked at our revelations. For we have certainly brought them a book which provides clear details based on knowledge and which is a guidance and a blessing for the true believers. Now are these people waiting for anything other than the day of fulfillment? When the day of fulfillment will come, those who have disregarded it will say, "Indeed, the Rasuls of our Rabb had come with the truth. Are there any intercessors now who could intercede on our behalf? Or could we be sent back so that we would not do as we have done before?" In fact, they would have lost their souls, and the things they had invented will leave them in the lurch.
إن ربكم الله الذي خلق السماوات والأرض في ستة أيام ثم استوى على العرش يغشي الليل النهار يطلبه حثيثا والشمس والقمر والنجوم مسخرات بأمره ألا له الخلق والأمر تبارك الله رب العالمين ادعوا ربكم تضرعا وخفية إنه لا يحب المعتدين ولا تفسدوا في الأرض بعد إصلاحها وادعوه خوفا وطمعا إن رحمة الله قريب من المحسنين وهو الذي يرسل الرياح بشرا بين يدي رحمته حتى إذا أقلت سحابا ثقالا سقناه لبلد ميت فأنزلنا به الماء فأخرجنا به من كل الثمرات كذلك نخرج الموتى لعلكم تذكرون والبلد الطيب يخرج نباته بإذن ربه والذي خبث لا يخرج إلا نكدا كذلك نصرف الآيات لقوم يشكرون
Surely your Rabb is Allah. He created the heavens and the earth in 6 yom and is firmly established on the throne of authority. He makes the night cover the day, and the day follow the night automatically. He created the sun, the moon, and the stars, and made them subservient to his will. Take note, his is the creation, and his is the command. Blessed is Allah, the Rabb of the worlds. Call on your Rabb with humility and in private, for he does not love the transgressors. Do not create mischief in the land after it has been set in order. Pray to him with fear and hope. Surely the mercy of Allah is always close to those who do good to others. He is the one who sends the winds bearing good news of his blessings. So when they lift up heavy clouds, we drive them along to a dead countryside and make the rain fall upon it and bring forth all kinds of fruit from the same dead land. Likewise, we will raise the dead to life. This example is given so that you may learn a lesson from this observation. The good soil yields rich produce by the permission of Allah, and barren soil yields nothing but poor produce. Thus do we explain our revelations over and over again for those who pay thanks.
لقد أرسلنا نوحا إلى قومه فقال يا قوم اعبدوا الله ما لكم من إله غيره إني أخاف عليكم عذاب يوم عظيم قال الملأ من قومه إنا لنراك في ضلال مبين قال يا قوم ليس بي ضلالة ولكني رسول من رب العالمين أبلغكم رسالات ربي وأنصح لكم وأعلم من الله ما لا تعلمون أوعجبتم أن جاءكم ذكر من ربكم على رجل منكم لينذركم ولتتقوا ولعلكم ترحمون فكذبوه فأنجيناه والذين معه في الفلك وأغرقنا الذين كذبوا بآياتنا إنهم كانوا قوما عمين
Indeed, we selected Nuh for the guidance of his people, and he said, O my people, worship Allah, you have no god but him. If you do not listen to what I say, I fear for you the punishment of a mighty day. The chiefs of his nation said, Surely we see that you are in evident error. He replied, O my people, I am not in error. On the contrary, I am a Rasul from the Rabb of the world. I am appointed to deliver the message of my Rabb and give you friendly advice, for I know from Allah something that you do not know. Do you wonder that there has come to you a message from your Rabb through a man from among yourselves to warn you so that you may fear Allah in order to receive his mercy? But they denied him. As a result, we saved him and all who were with him in the ark and drowned those who denied our revelations. Surely they were a blind nation.
وإلى عاد أخاهم هودا قال يا قوم اعبدوا الله ما لكم من إله غيره أفلا تتقون قال الملأ الذين كفروا من قومه إنا لنراك في سفاهة وإنا لنظنك من الكاذبين قال يا قوم ليس بي سفاهة ولكني رسول من رب العالمين أبلغكم رسالات ربي وأنا لكم ناصح أمين أوعجبتم أن جاءكم ذكر من ربكم على رجل منكم لينذركم واذكروا إذ جعلكم خلفاء من بعد قوم نوح وزادكم في الخلق بسطة فاذكروا آلاء الله لعلكم تفلحون قالوا أجئتنا لنعبد الله وحده ونذر ما كان يعبد آباؤنا فأتنا بما تعدنا إن كنت من الصادقين قال قد وقع عليكم من ربكم رجس وغضب أتجادلونني في أسماء سميتموها أنتم وآباؤكم ما نزل الله بها من سلطان فانتظروا إني معكم من المنتظرين فأنجيناه والذين معه برحمة منا وقطعنا دابر الذين كذبوا بآياتنا وما كانوا مؤمنين
For the people of Ad, we selected their brother Hud, who said, O my people, worship Allah, you have no god but him, will you not fear him? The chiefs of his nation who denied his message said, We can see that you are crazy, and we think that you are lying. He replied, O my people, I am not crazy, on the contrary, I am a Rasul from the Rabb of the world. I am conveying the message of my Rabb to you, and I am an honest adviser to you. Do you wonder that a reminder from your Rabb has come to you through one of your own men to warn you? Remember that he made you successors after the people of Nuh and gave you a tall stature as compared to other people. Therefore, remember the favors that you have received from Allah so that you may prosper. They replied, Have you come to us with the demand that we should worship Allah alone and give up those whom our forefathers used to worship? Well, bring us what you are threatening us with if what you say is true. Hud said, You have already incurred the blight and wrath of your Rabb. Would you dispute with me about mere names which you and your forefathers have invented and for which Allah has revealed no sanction? If so, then wait for the decision of Allah. I too will wait with you. We saved him and his companions by our mercy and cut off the roots of those who denied our revelations and did not become believers.
وإلى ثمود أخاهم صالحا قال يا قوم اعبدوا الله ما لكم من إله غيره قد جاءتكم بينة من ربكم هذه ناقة الله لكم آية فذروها تأكل في أرض الله ولا تمسوها بسوء فيأخذكم عذاب أليم واذكروا إذ جعلكم خلفاء من بعد عاد وبوأكم في الأرض تتخذون من سهولها قصورا وتنحتون الجبال بيوتا فاذكروا آلاء الله ولا تعثوا في الأرض مفسدين. قال الملأ الذين استكبروا من قومه للذين استضعفوا لمن آمن منهم أتعلمون أن صالحا مرسل من ربه قالوا إنا بما أرسل به مؤمنون. قال الذين استكبروا إنا بالذي آمنتم به كافرون. فعقروا الناقة وعتوا عن أمر ربهم وقالوا يا صالح ائتنا بما تعدنا إن كنت من المرسلين. فأخذتهم الرجفة فأصبحوا في دارهم جاثمين. فتولى عنهم وقال يا قوم لقد أبلغتكم رسالة ربي ونصحت لكم ولكن لا تحبون الناصحين.
For the people of Thamud, we selected their brother Saleh, who said, O my people, worship Allah. You have no other God but Him. Now a clear proof has come to you from your Rabb. Here is Allah's she-camel as a sign for you. Therefore leave her alone to pasture on Allah's land, and do not touch her with bad intentions, lest you incur a painful punishment. Remember how you were made the heirs of the Ad and settled in the land, capable of building mansions in the valleys and carving out homes in the mountains. Therefore remember the favors of Allah and do not spread mischief in the land. The arrogant leaders from his nation asked the oppressed among them who have believed, Do you really believe that Saleh is a Rasul from his Rabb? They replied, We do indeed believe in the revelation with which he has been sent. The arrogant who considered themselves superior said, We deny all that you believe in. Then they hamstrung the she-camel, defied the commandment of their Rabb, and challenged Saleh, saying, Bring down the scourge you have threatened us with, if you truly are one of the Rasuls. Thereupon an earthquake overtook them, and they became lifeless bodies in their homes with their faces down. Saleh left them, saying, O my people, I did convey to you the message of my Rabb, and you cried, but you did not love the good advisers.
ولوطا إذ قال لقومه أتأتون الفاحشة ما سبقكم بها من أحد من العالمين إنكم لتأتون الرجال شهوة من دون النساء بل أنتم قوم مسرفون. وما كان جواب قومه إلا أن قالوا أخرجوهم من قريتكم إنهم أناس يتطهرون. وأهله إلا امرأته كانت من الغابرين. وأمطرنا عليهم مطرا فانظر كيف كان عاقبة المجرمين.
We also selected Lut, who said to his people, Will you do such indecent acts as no one else in the world has committed before you? You satisfy your lust with men instead of women. Indeed, you are a nation who has transgressed beyond bounds. His people had no answer but to say, Drive them out of your town. They pose to be very pious. So we saved him and his family, except his wife, who was those who lagged behind. That rain crimson, every of them killed. He was the outcome for some criminals.
وإلى مدين أخاهم شعيبا قال يا قوم اعبدوا الله ما لكم من إله غيره قد جاءتكم بينة من ربكم فأوفوا الكيل والميزان ولا تبخسوا الناس أشياءهم ولا تبخسوا الناس أشياءهم ولا سواء في الطبع إصلاحها ذاكم خير لك إن كنتم مؤمنين لا تدوا بقسط توعون وصد مع سبيل لمن أمن تبغنها وإذ كنتم لا ثوم ضيفة أق مفسن إن طارم كنوا في
بوش
الله آمن تبغنها وجاء واذكروا كنتم لهم في الثوم وانظروا فنعاق الجدين وإن كطائف منهم أنوا الذي التطائف يؤصروا حياء الله لنا خياك
Mad their buzz is
up. أنا الذي رسلت به طائفا لم يفصوا فطروا تحكوا الله بينا وإرناك
For the missile brother said, Oh my Allah, you have not For the Madianian elected brother Shaib said, O people, Allah, who said, O my people, worship Allah, you have no other Adam. A guy has come from Ab, give measure, understand there, and make me a lad to have in all. If you don't enter from in him, wake behind you, and make a nation, yes, leave, have believe, and he is believers. Do not sit in ambush on every road to threaten people and hinder from the way of Allah those who believe in him, seeking to make his way crooked. Remember how he multiplied you when you were few in number, and see what was the end of the mischief makers of prior nations. If there are some among you who believe in the message with which I have been sent, and others who disbelieve in it, then be patient until Allah judges between us, for he is the best of all judges.